कैन यू प्लीज एलाबोरेट व्हाट इज डीबीएम?
ओके सर, डीबीएमएस इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ प्रोग्राम्स दैट मैनेजेस द डेटाबेस स्ट्रक्चर एंड कंट्रोल एक्सेस टू द डेटा स्टोर्ड इन द डेटाबेस. कलेक्शन ऑफ इंटर रिलेटेड एंड परसिस्टेंट ऑफ डेटा.
व्हाट पर्पस वी विल यूज डीबीएमएस?
DB database consists of organized collection and structured information. It can be consist of logically related data stored in a single data repository. We can use data in such a processed way. Information is in processing data. It's is accurate and relevant and timely inform the keys.
Do you aware about warehousing, data warehousing?
Yes, sir.
Can you please explore?
Yes, sir. Data warehouse stores data from similar or dissimilar, like enterprise data sources. The process of data warehouse is like it is in ETL form, like ETL stands for extract, transform, and loading. It will help to extract data from multiple separate sources. Transform data standard or uniform format and loads in data warehouse. Is a data warehouse is aggregate or summarized suitable for decision making. It maintains like a sing it maintains single version of truth and accumulates the historical data and use such data to the time series analysis like year or over year. The is not one more thing that the data in data warehouse is not updatable. It's introduced in 1970s by William Inmons, and it is a integrated subject oriented, non-volatile and time variant, and data warehouse and collection of data in support of management in decision making support.
All
Hello.
right. So can you please explain different types of keys which are available in database?
Okay, sir. We have different keys like candidate key, foreign key, primary key. We use that to identify each row of table uniquely and to maintain data integrity and to maintain relationships. Different type keys and relationship model like candidate, foreign, composite, alternate, and super key. The candidate key come for key that can be in any column or combination of columns that can qualify as unique key in database. For primary key, an attribute that uniquely identifies each row in a relation called primary key, combination of unique and null. And in foreign key, it must match with primary key or null key. It is used to relation it is used to relation between two tables using primary key. Foreign key used to link two tables together. Foreign key is a field or collection of fields in one table that refers to the primary key in another table. Composite key comes for the combination of one or two or more columns in table. So alternate comes from combination of two or more and that can work as a primary key, alternative key. Super key comes as a combination of columns that uniquely identifies only row in a row in a table with in re reduced minimum number of columns. Compound key contains any number of attributes as foreign key. That's it, sir. Hello?
Yeah, I'm there.
That's it, sir.
Okay.
Hello, please.
Can you please brief about normalization and denormalization?
Sir, normalization, no, sir.
Okay. Can you please tell me the syntax for how to create a table?
Create table, table name, column, and data type structures.
Yeah, give me an example.
Example, when we create table, student is the table name, and in that int roll number, class are the int roll number, roll number is in the int data type, and char name or var char name.
What is the difference between DDL and DML?
Yes, sir. DDL stands for data definition language, and DML stands for data manipulation language. DDL is to is used to alter and create, drop and rename the rename and truncate the tables, and we use DML for inserting, updating, and deleting, and for selecting the columns in the table. There are different uses for the two ones.
Yeah, understood. Please give me one example for each.
Okay, sir. DDL, in DDL, we can create table with the table name, and we can alter, like we can add, modify, drop table. When we take a student table, we create a student table with some column names, and we can alter that. We can add add some columns, add some student names, add some roll numbers, add some data into that. By using alter keyword, like add, modify, and drop, we can rename that in DDL student name. We can rename the table, whole table name, with another table, another new name. We can truncate each name, like delete. We can truncate that whole student table also. Like we can delete all records permanently into that, into the delete all the data from student table by using truncate. The same student table, when we take the same student table, we can insert the table, we can insert the names into that table by using insert, and we can update that whenever we want by using DML, and we can select some column list from table name, and we can modify that, and we can delete any data or any column from that DM from the table using delete key using DML.
Okay, can you please define what is a function?
Okay, so function is used to achieve reusability. Function can be it can be easy when we are using functions. Reduces complexity. It reduces complexity. It is error. It is more complex when we are using the normal procedural function. When we are using, it can be like splitting into small functions. We can easily find errors in that function, and we can do little bit fast when we are using functions.
Will you be able to differentiate between the stored procedure and functions?
Yes, sir. Function, stored procedure is, it's like a function program. When we are programming, the normal is in form of the function is in always in procedural. It can be a little bit complexity when compared to the function. In functions, we can easily find and rectify to the user in the absence of functions. any program having more complexity, it would be difficult, like it would be very difficult to find error by functions. It's easy.
So when we use functions and when we use stored procedure?
Well, it depends on program, and when we have a complex program, when it is a big program to create an application and more arguments, more functions, definitions, that more definitions, when we have a lot of program, a big program, then we use functions to easily debugging and to rectify errors. If there are any errors in big in that whole program, we can find error easily. In small programs, we use procedural, like if you have any error, that we can easily find in a short form of program.
All right. You want to know the difference between truncate and drop?
Truncate means it will delete all the detail records in the table permanently. Drop means it can delete rows and columns in the table, not permanently.
So what is the syntax that you use for both the cases?
We use truncate keyword and then table and table name, whatever it is, a student or a customer or anything. Truncate, table, table name for truncate, and for drop, alter table and table name, drop column name, which we want to drop that column from drop table, table name, or for the old table, drop table, table name.
What will happen if I use drop table, table name?
The entire table will be deleted.
Is there any possible to change the column name?
Yes, sir, we can change.
How we can do that?
By column name is not possible. In records, we can change the data.
No, let us say I have already 5 columns, which I have already defined while creating a table. Now, I have decided that in the 5th column, I want to change to 6th column. Let us say column 5, I want to name it as a column 6. Is it possible?
Yes, sir, we can.
Can you please give me syntax for that?
Alter, modify. Alter table, we can modify that column name. Alter table, the table name, and modify column name, and then data type with size. We can modify that column name, or we can modify the table name also.
Okay, how will you load data from one table to another table? What is the lines of code that you will write in SQL?
SQL, I don't know that much, sir.
So how will you load data into a table?
By creating table, by first we can create table, and then we can insert all the tables into that records.
Yeah, just tell me, how will you insert a records into a table?
Okay, sir. The syntax?
Yes.
Okay, sir. Insert into the table name, which we are want to insert the records into the table, and then values, we have to give the values like value 1, 2, and so on, the semicolon at last. We can update select those column names, and we can modify all that.
So do you think in real time also we will do the manually?
Manually, we can't do that.
Then there should be some process, right, to load data in from one table to another table?
Yes, sir.
What is the difference between tuple and a dictionary?
Okay, sir. Tuple is like similar to list. It's like collection of multiple elements of different data type. It is immutable. Like when we create a table, we can't update or delete. We can't do anything. It's immutable. When we have to insert or create anything, we can create another table in that we can do any manipulation. We can't do in the same table any modifications. Dictionary is multiple elements with no duplicate keys. It is in key value pairs. It is enclosed in square brackets, any data type will be taken in dictionaries. We can add, modify, and delete the rows and columns in dictionaries. There are some methods in dictionaries like clear, copy items, and the keys, values, updates, like some pop item like the dupe. For coming to tuple, there are some methods like length, concatenation, repetition, and membership. And tuples is enclosed in brackets with the comma separated values.
Okay. Sets allow duplicates?
Sets?
Allows duplicates?
No, sir. It avoids duplicates. It removes duplicates.
What about tuple?
Tuples allows duplicates.
What is the difference between tuples and sets? Is that only a duplicates part, or is there anything else?
No, sir. Tuples is immutable. When it comes to set, set is mutable. We can add, delete, and reassign the columns and records. In sets, there is no indexing and no slicing. Elements in sets are unordered. It can be in any order. Elements in set, enclosed set is also in square brackets. Collection of multiple elements with different data types. It can contain any data type in sets.
So you said sets, we are using square brackets. Is it correct?
Yes, sir, it's correct.
What about list?
List we use in square brackets.
Sets also we use square brackets, and list also we are using square brackets, huh?
No, sir. It's flower brackets. Sorry. Sets is in flower brackets.
What about dictionary?
So dictionary is used in also flower bracket dictionary key value pairs.
So dictionary and sets both we are representing with flower brackets, you are saying?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir. It's flower bracket.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Bianca.